All right, what's next? So far, you've done your scoping, internal and external. You've developed your issues, your alternatives, you've done your affected environment, you've analyzed your environmental consequences. As you know, there's other tasks that are involved in the NEPA process. For example, if you're writing an EA, you need to write a FONSI, a finding of no significant impact, if you find no significant impacts. You'll conduct public reviews, you'll analyze your comments, and you'll need to write a decision. Because we limited this course just to Chapter 6 of the BLM NEPA Handbook, which is the steps of the analytical process under NEPA, there are other topics that you might want to learn about. And to find out about these other topics, you can look at the other chapters of the NEPA Handbook, or you can take any of the our myriad other online and classroom courses. And you can find those by going, of course, to the Resources tab on the left side of your screen. Now we'll summarize what you learned in this NEPA Analytical Process course. If you could get out your participant guide and turn to Exercise 6, then you can jot down the top 10 take-home messages for NEPA analysis. Jolie?
Number 10, the purpose in need is BLM's purpose in need for action.
Number 9, some form of public involvement is required for all EAs.
Number 8, the proposed action must cover who, what, how, when, and where.
Number 7, address the no action alternative in all EAs.
Number 6, develop analytical methodology and analytical assumptions early in the process.
Number 5, your analysis should be limited to analyzing just the issues.
Number 4, cite and summarize existing analysis and decisions to limit the scope of your analysis and gain efficiency.
Number 3, we must take a hard look at environmental impacts.
Number 2, your analysis must build a solid pyramid of evidence.
And the number 1, top 10 NEPA take-home message is, the point of the NEPA process is to make better decisions.
Thank you for that. I hope you all got that jotted down in your exercise. We have one final exercise, exercise 7. It's called Bringing It Home. We know how it is when you take a class, everything makes sense at the time, you're all jazzed up. And then comes the weekend and you go camping, show up to work on Monday, and you have no idea what you did last week, much less what you learned. So we are going to stop that vicious cycle by doing one more exercise. What I'd like you to do is think about everything that you've learned over the past couple hours. Think about the notes you took, the tidbits you heard during the summary. And the first thing you should do here on your paper is write down what you're going to do differently in the NEPA process as a result of what you learned during this class. Because don't forget, if you keep doing what you've always done, you'll keep getting what you've always gotten. Take your time, think about it. Think about each step we went through. Think about what you work on the most, what you have the toughest time with, where you think you're the weakest. Be as clear and complete as you can so it will make sense to you when you look at it next week or next year. Second thing is to write down what you need to do even better NEPA analysis. Is it focused training on a certain step of NEPA? Is it clearer direction from your manager? Maybe a shadow assignment, an interdisciplinary team meeting to talk about what's next in the process? Write those down. And then the last step will be to send your answers to me here at the National Training Center so I can see what you came up with. It'll help us with future training and just help me compare across the BLM how we're doing. If you need somebody else to help you be successful with this, then talk to him, her, or them about it if you're new to BLM and want to chat about it. We have several other National Training Center classes. There's several online and classroom classes and broadcasts on various different NEPA and planning topics. If you'd like to know more about them, go to the Resources tab on your screen and you'll find out more information. We do have a NEPA Analysis for EAs, a 3-day classroom course. It gives you opportunities to practice writing and reviewing EAs so you can put this analysis process to work. And if you're interested in any of those courses, contact me or Mark Chamberlain to request one. In order for BLM employees to get credit for this course, you need to get at least 80% on the post-test. If you got to this course through DOI Learn, you'll see how to get to the post-test. If you access this through our Knowledge Resource Center, or KRC, you'll need to log into DOI Learn, go to My Courses, then to Online Courses, and then take the test. I'd like to thank our instructors, and I'd like to thank all of you for your time, and good luck in your future NEPA endeavors.